Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. I really want to thank everyone who called in with questions for the Netcast. If you'd like to call in, just leave a message on my voicemail, 866-581-0221. As I mentioned before, the podcast started out really going through the book, Learn Excel from Mr. Excel, and we've gotten to the point where I've talked about all 277 items in the book, almost, and so I really need people to call in and give me new ideas. Today we have a call.
Hi, Bill. My name's Christian. I think your podcast is great. Quick question. One of my job functions is to compare sets of employee ID lists using the VLOOKUP function in Excel to my matches. Each ID is exactly 5 digits long. The problem is when I enter the data, Excel doesn't keep leaf zeros, which are part of the ID. To solve my problem, I must format the list as a 5-digit zip code, then I can do the VLOOKUP comparison. How can I keep leaving zeros for 2, 3, 4 digit lines? Myself. Thanks.
Hey, that's a great question. The zip code format is something I never even thought of. If you select some cells and use format cells and then choose the special category, you can choose zip code, which will force everything to have 5 digits. But of course, that only works if your employee ID is 5 digits long. What if you need leading zeros and something that is 3, 4, 5, or 6? Well, there's a couple of different ways to go. The first way, which is a little bit annoying, but will actually work out better in the long run, is instead of entering a number like 00123 and have Excel remove those leading zeros, put in an apostrophe and then 00123. The apostrophe tells Excel that we're not going to treat this as a number, it shouldn't be evaluated, and it will actually keep it as text. So that's one way to go. The apostrophe would be very frustrating if you had lots of employee IDs to enter. But the advantage there is that, again, it would work with 1, 2, 3, 4 leading zeros instead of the zip code format. The other way to go, and there's some gotchas when you use this, is to pre-select your range and use format cells and then format the entire range as text. Once it's formatted as text, now if you enter the leading zeros, 0, 1, 2, 3, it will keep the leading zeros. Text formatting, though, is a really evil kind of thing. The problem with text formatting is that if you have something formatted as text and you enter a formula, equal to times the number somewhere, instead of evaluating the formula, it leaves the formula as text. Very annoying kind of thing to have the text format. So I probably would kind of recommend just using the apostrophe. Apostrophe 00123, Excel will keep the leading zeros for you and convert just that cell to text. If the apostrophe is really too frustrating, then go through and format the whole range of employee IDs as text, and then as you enter them, it will keep the leading zeros. And if you happen to have an employee ID that's 5, I love the idea of using the zip code format to force the leading zeros to be there. Of course, the place where that really comes in handy is with US zip codes. On the East Coast, we have zip codes that start with 0. And if you don't format them as zip codes, then we'll lose the leading zeros for all of those customers on the East Coast. Hey, thanks. That was a great call. If you have a call for the podcast, just call us, 866-581-0221, and we'll get to your question. See you tomorrow for another Excel 2007 Thursday. Thanks for stopping by.